It's important to be able to use the different PowerPoint views when you are developing your presentation. One of the last things I do before printing is to go through my presentation one more time in Slide Sorter and Slideshow View. Right now, the Normal View command is selected. This is where you create and edit your slides. When you are ready to change views, just click the command. Slide Sorter View is where the slides are displayed horizontally. This allows you to see more slides in the window and verify you have the correct number of slides. I always do a quick check and make sure they are all here to ensure I haven't deleted any slides by mistake. You may not be able to see all the text on each slide, but you can use a zoom tool to zoom in when you need to, or zoom out. I also quickly check the general organization of my slides. Slide Sorter View is a good view to make sure everything flows the way you want. Let's see. I think I want this team slide to come before the exercise. Slide Sorter is great for moving slides around. You also have Slideshow View, which launches the slide that is selected and fills the computer screen. This is the view of the presentation the audience will see. Let's see. I'll just select slide 1 and then click the slideshow command. To move through the slides, you have several options. You can use the arrows or the page up and page down keys to move forwards and backwards. You can even press the space bar or enter key to move forward. Also, if you move your cursor to the bottom left part of the slide, you'll see a small menu appear. You can click these arrows to move to the next or previous slide, or click the icon with lines to access a menu. From the menu, you can move to the next or previous slide, jump to a specific slide, change your screen options, or just end the show. If you right-click anywhere in the presentation, a similar menu will appear that provides you with many of the same options. If you ever want to end the show, you can choose it from this menu or just press the Escape key on your keyboard. An interesting option is the pin command. If you click it, a menu appears that allows you to change your cursor to a ballpoint pen, a felt tip pen, or a highlighter. You can even choose the color. Let's see. I'll choose highlighter. You may be wondering how you could use this. Let's say you are talking to a large group and you want to draw their attention to the third bullet on slide 8. You didn't format it differently when you created the slide, but you can draw attention to it now. I can just click and drag my highlighter across the text. If you are working with a complex line graph or chart, these tools might be helpful to draw attention to a specific part. You could even use one of the pens to circle specific information. When you reach the end of the presentation, you will have to choose whether you want to keep or discard the annotations or notes you made, and then you revert back to normal or slideshow view, whichever view was active before you launched the slideshow. In addition to these three views, which you can access from the bottom of the PowerPoint's window, there is a fourth view called Notes Page View that you don't see as a command. To access all four views, select the View tab. You will see the four view commands on the left side of the presentation's view group. The Normal, Slide Sorter, and Slideshow commands work just the same from here. Let's click the Notes Page View to see what that looks like. As you can see, the slide is on top of the page with a placeholder area for text below it. This is so you can type notes to help you when you present. These are often called speaker notes. These are formatted so you can print them and have the slide and your notes together on the same page. You have two options. You can enter your notes here in Notes Page View or in the Notes section of Normal View. What you enter here will appear in the Notes Page View. Once you're sure your presentation looks like you want and you've proofread it carefully, you may want to print the slides for the audience. Sometimes when you give a presentation, you may only want the audience to see the slides on the screen, while other times you may want to give them a hard copy of the presentation to look at or take home with them. Now that I'm sure my slides don't have any misspelled words, I can print copies of the slides for my audience or myself. Before I do this, I usually flip through each slide one more time. You can use the slides tab in the pane on the left, the scroll bar, or just do what I do and use the arrow keys on the keyboard. If you do want to print, select the Microsoft Office button and choose Print. You have Print, Quick Print, and Print Preview options. I personally don't use Print Preview very often, but from here, you can make some decisions about what you are printing and your color options. I don't use this very much because you can do a lot of the same things from the Print dialog box. Let's select Print instead. The Print dialog box appears. If you have more than one printer, you can select the one you want to use. You can click Properties and make some additional choices. I'm not going to show you this since it varies so much from printer to printer. You can choose to print all the slides or list only a few. If you decide to enter only a few, just list them like they are in the example here. Now, the important part is to decide what you want to print. If you select OK right now, each slide will be on its own page. If your slideshow has many slides, this can use a lot of paper. You may want to print handouts, which prints a smaller version of each slide with more than one slide on a page. If you choose this option, you then have to decide how many slides to print to a page. The default is 6, but you can change that to 3 and have room for the person to take notes, or choose some other number. Depending on which number you choose, you may have the option to choose whether you want the slides displayed horizontally or vertically. If you typed speaker notes in PowerPoint, you can also print notes pages. I'll just leave this as a handout with 6 slides to a page. You also have the option to print in grayscale or color, and you need to choose the number of copies to print. Collate is selected by default, which is probably what you want, so all the pages will print in the correct order. Once you have made all the decisions, you are ready to click OK. Now it's time to print your slides.